Hi, this is Joe Bass with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. I'd like to take the time to show you a trailer I took in on trade that I think you're going to like as much as I do. It's one that I would like to have. It's roomy, but yet it's fairly short. And it's set up in such a way that it has a lot of sleeping, and the bedroom is not very confined. It's actually really roomy in the bedroom. You don't always get that in tow trailers, so that's what I like about this one. So this is a hideout. They call it a 23 RKS for rear kitchen. It has dual 7.5 gallon propane tanks with dual batteries. Now this one was bought here brand new back in 2011, and the people traded it in for another brand new hideout. They liked this one a lot, but they wanted a rear living unit, and that's the only reason why they traded it in. Other than that, they loved it. It's got pass-through storage right here. Goes all the way across. And what's nice about these hideouts as well is they build these in the same line that the Cougars are built. So the same guys that put together the Cougars build the hideout in the same factory. It's got a sewer flush right here on this side that you can flush out your black tank with. And as you notice, there's dual doors. So you got a bedroom door and you have a rear entry right there on the back. You got a place for an exterior TV if you want to hook one up here. There's your cable connection and your power connection right there. So you could mount a TV out here on a table if you wanted to. We have an awning that goes quite a long ways. It goes from the back of the front door all the way to the far side of the rear door. And this comes with an extra spare tire and a bracket, with a rear exterior ladder as well. Now this one has a slide, a sofa slide, and when these people bought this one brand new, they opted to put the slide topper on over the slide. What's nice about that, it keeps the debris off the top of the slide so you don't end up with branches and leaves gathering on top of that. And the reason why that is so nice is when you go to bring that slide in, it pushes all that stuff off the top, so you don't have to get up there and sweep it before you pull the slide in. Now the water heater is a gas electric 6 gallon hot water heater. Why I like the gas and electric together is it heats at 16.2 gallons per hour, so the recovery rate is a lot higher than just a gas one. So this is a nice feature to have. You got satellite prep here as well. As you come over to this side, you're going to see you have your pull valves are right here, your gray and your black. One thing I also want to point out is the decals on this are in immaculate shape. I mean, this unit's like brand new. The people used it very little just because they don't go camping a lot, but they do like to use it when they go. Let's go take a look at the inside and I'll show you some of the internal features. Now, as you come into the inside, you're going to see the vinyl floor here. The vinyl floor is throughout. There is no carpeting in this unit whatsoever. And the vinyl floors have no wear or tear at all on them. They look brand new. And you got a countertop here that actually covers this whole corner of this unit. Here's your gas electric controls for your hot water heater and your slide control for the Davenport slide. You have lots of storage drawers here as well as storage cabinets up here. Now you have a 6 cubic foot fridge with a microwave and a stovetop with an oven. And what's nice about this unit is the way they design it. They design the heat that runs next to all of the lines, all of your water lines. So when you're using the furnace, it's impossible for those water lines and tanks to freeze up because they put them right alongside those, right alongside the furnace line, the ducting. So it's just not going to freeze up. It's a great design. We spent a lot of time thinking about how they could do this, have the belly insulated and heat those lines up without having separate heating pads on there to eat a lot of battery. And that's the way they design it. Works great. Folks that buy these things don't have a problem freezing up in the wintertime. Now this is what they call a scissor bed. It actually opens up like that and you can sleep someone right here. And you have a nice storage area right here for hanging clothes. Over here at the dinette, this makes up into a bed as well. So you got sleeping for virtually six people in here. Also has air conditioning, all ducted throughout the unit. And it comes with a 19-inch flat screen TV that also has a built-in DVD player with a radio. It has a USB port on auxiliary in for an iPod connection and a spot for earphones. So you got a big window here. You got another nice window here. You got two windows back in the kitchen area. So it's a nice, light, bright unit. You have another storage area right here for like a little pantry. Now as we come back into the bedroom, this is why I like this one. For people that feel a little claustrophobic back in the bedroom, this is kind of like a split bath, which you normally see in fifth wheels. Well, they designed it into this trailer. So you got a queen size bed with an enclosed glass shower right here with a sink. And it's really roomy in this area. Again, you got two more closets here next to the headboard. And it comes with another 19-inch flat screen TV in the bedroom. This is a nice unit, folks. If you want something that's inexpensive, that you can go out and have fun with, sleep family of six, and want something that's built well, you got to come check out this hideout, this 23 RKS rear kitchen. Come see Joe Bass at the RV Corral. I'd love to work with you. I'd love to talk about bass fishing or just outside camping. I love to do it. I do it myself. I own my own RV, and my wife and I love going out as well. So let's exchange stories, and let's talk about how I can get you into this RKS. Love to have your trade. Come see Joe Bass at the RV Corral. Love to meet you. Thank you.